Welcome to your very own PTS walkthrough guide. After watching this short video, you will be able to begin operating your brand new PTS. In order to begin your testing, you will need several different items. First, you will need your Endosafe PTS unit. You will also need the power supply and adapter cord for charging the PTS. It is highly recommended before beginning your test that the unit has been completely charged. Also, do not leave the unit plugged in more than is necessary for it to be fully charged, or the battery life will be reduced. You will also need the printer we supply for printing results. We recommend you use a calibrated fixed volume 25 microliter pipetter with Eppendorf BioPure pipette tips. However, if you do not have a 25 microliter pipetter, we do supply a mini pipetter that is helpful when you are getting started. It is very important that tips are pyrogen free. Please note, do not use cotton-filled pipette tips with your pipetter. Finally, you will need the cartridges. It is important for any refrigerated cartridges to be warm to room temperature prior to use. To begin the process, turn the PTS reader on by pressing the menu key. After pressing the menu key, the reader begins a system self-test and will take approximately 5 minutes to reach the appropriate 37 degrees Celsius. Once the reader reaches this temperature, the display will change from system self-test to insert cartridge. You are ready to begin. Before doing so, if you have refrigerated the cartridge, please remove it from the refrigerator and allow it to warm to room temperature unopened while still in its pouch. Once at room temperature, please remove your cartridge from its pouch by only touching the edges of the cartridge. You will notice there is a desiccant in the pouch which can be discarded. Once the cartridge is fully removed, do your best to touch only the handle end of the cartridge as you begin to place it in the reader. At this time, with the wells facing up, insert the cartridge gently, then pressing firmly all the way into the slot at the front of the reader. Once the cartridge has been firmly inserted into the PTS, the reader prompts the user to enter the following information. Enter the operator ID. Enter the lot number, which is the cartridge lot number. Enter the calibration code if it is a new cartridge lot. Please note the calibration code is lot specific and different for each batch of cartridges. Lot number confirms the cartridge lot number has been entered. Enter sample lot number. Enter the sample ID. You can select and scroll with the menu key under the sample ID header, which allows for 50 samples to be entered and stored. Enter dilution factor. Here we are testing LAL water undiluted by pressing 1. However, if you have to dilute a sample, then enter 10 on the keypad for a 1 to 10 dilution. If the calibration code for the particular lot number has already been entered, the PTS reader does not prompt for the code again. To erase all stored lot numbers and corresponding calibration codes, select Menu 2, then 4. Please note, all LAL reagent water used to make product dilutions should be tested for the absence of detectable endotoxin. While the above information is being entered into the PTS reader, the cartridge is being pre-warmed. After entering your information, the PTS reader displays Add Sample. Carefully pipette 25 microliters of sample into all 4 sample reservoirs of the inserted cartridge. To do so, hold the pipette so that the tip is at an angle and not completely at the bottom of the sample reservoir. After you have accurately determined each of the 4 sample reservoirs has 25 microliters, press Enter on the keypad. If using a one-stop pipetter, like the mini pipetter, push down the plunger all the way to pick up and dispense the sample. If you're using a two-stop pipetter, such as a calibrated Eppendorf pipetter, push the plunger down to the first stop to pick up the sample. For reliable results, it is important that you pipette the sample properly. You need exactly 25 microliters of sample for the test. Do not underfill the well or overfill the well, and do not pipette straight up and down, touching the bottom of the well. Also, be careful not to create bubbles when adding the sample. After the assay is complete, the results will appear on the screen. This data can then be printed or downloaded to your computer. If your printer is on during the test, it will automatically print. In order to download the results to your computer, follow these simple steps. Step 1. Connect the cable provided in the packaging with the PTS from the back of the reader to your PC. Step 2. Select Connect, then choose the COM port your PTS reader is connected to in the Setup Communications window. At the end, click on the Connect button to connect to the reader. Step 3. Select Log, then Open Close Log to open the log. Step 4. Press the Menu key on the PTS reader keypad. For the Print menu, press 4. Step 5. Select Log, then View to view data in Notepad format. If you choose to print, after selecting 4, there will be 3 options for downloading data to the printer. 1. Print last test, 2. Print by date, and 3. Print all tests. Selecting one of the 3 choices on the PTS reader keypad will send results to the connected printer. Please keep in mind that printing data directly through a portable printer or through the EndoScan V software constitutes an official record of the assay. Now that you have gone through the steps, you are ready to begin using your brand new PTS and begin getting results in as little as 15 minutes. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact our offices at 1-800-762-7016 or endo-comments@crl.com.